to my shipper and Tracy. I'll check if this is actually going to record my dash cam. California. Got 75 miles to go to Tracy. Don't freeze up. Started as well, so it's ready for it's already set at negative 10, so we're good. This freaking dash cam wants to be temperamental again. It's because of the external camera. Morning, Corey. Nah, I can't keep screwing around with that dash cam, so. Tired here, so still could go for more sleep, but it's enough to get me to my customer. There, but idle for the next few loads. Not sure what's all going on there, but yeah, I guess they need local help for, you know, running back and forth between these customers. Dumb dog. Yeah. I hate that when that happens. Where you at now? Oh, you're getting a pretty good distance down there then. Yeah, I had to take a nap too. That's why I ended up stopping for about an hour. I could have made it all the way to my customer, but I don't. Well, then it turns out they would have told me to come back anyway till my appointment time. So, yeah, that was good. Ah, okay. Which I don't really have that. I think I remember you saying something about who the customer was. I don't think I had been to them before. Sigma, okay. We're at Laredo. Really? Wow. Huh. God, I've been there countless times, although I've only been there twice with JCT. Do you remember the name of the place? Yeah, both places that I delivered to down there, I think it was like 80 or some shit cash. Oh, 255. Yeah, if it's a toll road, it's probably 255. It's probably up on the like north end, north of Laredo. Yeah, the only toll road I can think of down that way is 255. Yep, it's that same area where I was at last time I was there. Yeah, you'll be able to park on the street there if you're going to the area where I think you're going. Speaking of when I was there last time, they were building their lifts right next door to the place that I was picking up from. What was it, U.S. Cold Storage or whatever hell it was? Oh, okay. Yeah, there are a few of them down there, but yeah, there's a brand new U.S. cold storage facility up there, up north of town. Yeah, not quite to mine. Yeah, I'm going up. I don't know if it's open yet, but they were building it when I was actually picking up there at U.S. cold storage last time. So it may or may not be open by now. Yeah, and it's literally in the it's basically like a cul-de-sac you have to use to get to the guard shack at U.S. Cold Storage. Well,
Yeah, well, if it's the same one, there basically you go onto some cul-de-sac road to get to it, and then you turn right at the end of the cul-de-sac to get to where the guard shack is. And that same cul-de-sac on the left side, right there at the corner of Mines Road and that cul-de-sac is where they're building that Love's. Or it may be open by now, I don't know. It's been a few months. Black Diamond Road, that sounds familiar. I'll take a look when I get to my shipper. It sounds that street name sounds very familiar. Pig snouts, huh? Crunch, crunch, crunch. If you're going across 255 to get to your customer, if it's to the if you're going to the same US cold storage, all you have to do is just go like barely a block or so west of the complex, industrial park, whatever you want to call it, and that'll take you to Mines Road, and then Mines Road is that's like the main drag that'll take you straight down to Laredo. I forget that number. It's an F number. Price now, but they still had a pretty good amount of work to do on it. So I wouldn't. Well, but then again, they had a lot to do on that Flying J in Fontana when they built it, or renovated, whatever you want to call it. And yeah, the Peterbilt dealer where I always take my truck. Okay, Cherry Avenue. That's been a while. What's wrong with that? It's entertainment. Sure, I guess. I don't pay attention to that idiot. The states with the most populous cities, that's about it. You say so. I guess that's what happens when you have too many social programs. Especially when you got programs that are set up where it's easy for people to abuse them, take advantage of them just because they can. Yay! So if it's almost 6 a.m. there, I don't think you should be able to start finding parking there. Well, yeah, I know, but still, it's almost 6 a.m. You're in Texas regardless. Okay. I'm coming up on Santanella. Going up, yeah, going up to Tracy. No, I'm actually picking up a load at US Cold Storage. And I'll be taking that down to San Diego to some place that's literally a block away from the Mexican border. And I guess I'm going back up from San Diego to Tracy. And basically, I'm going back and forth between San Diego and Tracy, is from what it sounds like, for like three or four loads in a row. They're needing help with from local drivers, whatever, on basically that run there. Not sure what's going on there, but I guess I'll figure it out as I do it. Jackass. I'm doing 45 and a 65, 70, whatever it is. What an idiot. Sure. It's, honestly, I'm not. I mean, they've eaten some of the restrictions in some spots, like the Loves in Lost Hills. They just stopped there, and apparently, you can self-serve your drinks again, which caught me by surprise because I was like, every Loves I've been to lately, they are doing their, basically it's full service where you have, they have to do it for you. And I go there and like, oh wow, self-serve, okay. Like, I'm bad to even ask just because, like, I've been so long. But I've not tried to eat at restaurants lately, but far as I know, yeah, the restaurants are mostly all still closed except for takeout and drive-through, and some of them you have to call or... I've got the chicken coop in Santanella coming up in a couple miles. I'm getting rid of... I'm actually passing by Rotten Robbie's and TA and all that now. All right. All right, sounds good. Yeah, I don't think I'll be streaming too long. I don't know. I'm assuming it might take at least an hour, a couple hours, whatever, to load. And I figure when I'm done, I might just come down here to Santanella and end my day or something. All right. Okay. Bye-bye.
out on Interstate 5. Basically going toward the Stockton area. My shipper is in Tracy, not far off of I-5. there are ruts in the road where, you know, where trucks run. And you're, yeah, of course, naturally, you don't stay in the middle of it. When you're not in the middle of it, it wants to throw you toward the opposite side of it.
See you.
drove past the radio, Auto Club Speedway, there on the NASCAR track in Fontana on the way to the dealer earlier, and man, there were a whole bunch of cars parked in the lot there. But there was not even a single soul in the stands there, so I'm like, okay, why are so many cars here? What the hell is going on?
it.
Tracy right now, actually. I'll be at my shed for any very soon. I think is going to be the road that I'll be turning on to. Basically a Leprino load. Pickup number. Okay. gates opening for this other driver right now.
You have 3 hours and 59 minutes of remaining drive time.
gotta be
you
able
have 3 hours and 57 minutes of remaining drive time.
I gotta back in next to this U.S. Foods truck. It's way out up in front of its door. Here. my pocket in the back, so this is how my pickup information on it. Yeah, it does. So we'll need that. Alright. Let's return. Turns out he needs my PO number, so I'll be back. coming in, they're ready to load me. Not sure if they're going to stage the product first before they come out or what. Let's see. Seems to have snowed in Nevada, but warm and rainy here in the southeast. Yeah, I saw something about, actually Donner Pass, I remember Tara. Tara posted, I guess, I don't know if it was Scotty's stream footage or what, but it looked like Donner Pass got dumped on pretty good. Like, yeah, pretty good strong snowstorm up there. Warm and sunny, and damn it, Paso Robles. Yeah, it's 58 degrees here. Like clear skies, and it was a little on the cool side of my house in Victorville. Actually, it was cooler in Victorville than it was in San Bernardino, which is odd. Normally, it's the other way around. Watching the loader guy, or whatever. All right, 3-day weekend. Memorial Day. Yeah, I guess that's next week. Oh. Looks like my trainer just picked up in Pottsville, Arkansas. Coming out this way to Stockton for Saturday delivery. Stop off at the house. Alright, so I'll have to get in touch with him. Let him know I'm running back and forth between here and here in San Diego, basically for the next several days. James, today is reopened camping here, Missouri. Yeah, you would think that camping would be, it would have never been closed. It was like, come on, people are generally not around other people when you're out on the, yeah, out in the wilderness going camping. It's like even when I'd go hiking, you know, up in the mountains. Even on on permitted trails, you were only allowed so many people on each trail per day, and it's not like you were gonna have cross paths with every damn person on the mountain, on the way up. Well, depending on which trail you're on, some of them they would, I would come across other people, but not okay, just kind of passing by. It's I have closer contact in the store. But then there's there are other ones that are busier. Yeah, and get a lot more traffic there. Thought he was gonna turn there. Or he just figured out the hard way that he's not supposed to come in from here, I guess, or going across the street place, I don't know. Alright, only Kansas is not reopened yet. Bars, stuff like that, a lot of people not happy. Yeah. A lot of stuff still not open here either, as far as I know. Of course, I've not paid much mind to any of that. At least I think they're opening some schools back up here and getting people back to work if they can do so. Yeah, here in California, the schools are closed for the rest of the school year. Let's see, get rid of that. See the fake news I posted on Critter's page about Oklahoma. I saw you guys talking about fake news on there, but I think I was just so busy, just kind of went through real fast. I didn't pay attention to what it was about. I saw like a link or whatever, or a meme or whatever the hell it was. But yeah, I'm late. I might go ahead and I know I'm gonna want to get some rest too, and I don't know how long it'll be before they're ready to load me and once they are ready, it'll take some time to get loaded as well. So, let's see, I'm kind of already. All right. So, what I might do is just go ahead and end the stream for now, and then, let's see, I got 353 left to work with, 438 left on my 14, so really I can still get over 200 miles of driving before the end of my shift. That can actually get me all the way down to Kettleman City or Lost Hills before I run out of time. But depending on how long they keep me here, because my 14 is going to be an issue, and I'll have to get my, I'll have to scale my load on the way out as well. So, I don't know, I might end up stopping in Santanella regardless, but if not, there's not really truck stops in Kettleman City, but assuming that I can reach Kettleman but not Lost Hills, that's another area. That's another spot I can consider, but yeah, I just figured maybe I'll stop in Santanella. Either way, I get option to have In-N-Out Burger. If they'll cater to trucks at least, so I don't know, I kind of picture myself in my morning at Rotten Robbie's in Santanella, and then just say, the hell with it, I'll get some rest, and then I'll run a 400-mile shift from there down to San Diego, do another 10-hour break in San Diego, and deliver in the morning or whatever. I don't have an appointment time yet for the delivery, so I'll find that out probably sometime today. All right, guys, look like Target and Lowe's had good earnings reports this morning. Nice. All right, I'm going to give me some rest, at least while I can, and whenever I do leave here, it'll at least be a 50-mile drive. I'll go ahead and stream that for you guys to hang out, and I'll see you guys then, all right? Or dose.